You can say what you like about Asus, but there's no denying it's broken the mold like no other with its Android Honeycomb tablets. First, there was the Eee Pad Transformer, which was the only Android tablet that could also double as a convincing netbook. And now we have the Eee Pad Slider, which is arguably even more interesting. Its USP is once again the keyboard, but the design is perhaps even more ambitious here. It doesn't flip out, but slides out courtesy of a metal hinge at the back. The keyboard is non-removable and only sits happily in one position once extended. In this respect, it's less flexible than the Transformer, but it does have a certain sci-fi cool to it, as the sort of gadget you might have seen in a movie from the 90s. The quality of the keyboard is much better than that of most third-party Android accessories that litter the market. Keys feel solid, and the action is not far off what you get with a proper laptop. However, it does feel a bit cramped, and the layout takes a little getting used to. The keyboard naturally also adds a bit to the tablet's girth. The slider is 17.3 millimeters thick and weighs a hearty 960 grams. Hardly an iPad 2 rival then, but it's a little thinner than the Transformer with its keyboard dock attached. Its keyboard makes the slider a much more attractive productivity tool than most tablets, and clearly aware of this, Asus has added a full-size USB port on its right edge. This will let you plug in mice or external hard drives, further boosting its versatility. There's only a micro SD slot on the tablet, not a full-size jobby, but you could always plug a memory card reader into the USB slot. The slightly studious style of the slider hasn't led to compromises for its screen, thankfully. It uses a fab IPS display with the same 1280 by 800 pixel resolution seen in most top Android Honeycomb tablets, and the same responsive capacitive touchscreen. Aside from a couple of Asus app extras, the slider runs a pretty vanilla version of Android Honeycomb 3.2. There's a Tegra 2 processor under the bonnet, which has no problem keeping the OS ticking along nicely. And, of course, the tablet has full access to the Android market and its giant library of apps ranging from the good to the catastrophically awful. Built-in video support is as poor as we've come to expect from an Android Honeycomb tablet, with no native support for DivX or Xvid. Also, the battery power doesn't rise above the average at around 8 hours, perhaps a bit disappointing considering how big and heavy it is, relatively speaking. The Asus Eee Pad Slider is a bit of an oddball in several respects, but it's one that deserves to be celebrated. It has the responsive touchscreen, great display, and power of the other Honeycomb tablets, plus serious productivity benefits thanks to its keyboard. And yet, it doesn't cost much more than rivals. We'd still tend to favour the Transformer for its increased flexibility and battery life, but if it's going to stay at home, this is a worthy and surprisingly stylish alternative.